Google unveiled new AI features.
Yeah, it's an all-out effort to compete with ChatGPT. Rich DeMuro has that in today's Rich on Tech.
At this year's Google I.O., no new hardware announcements. Instead, Google spent nearly 2 hours detailing all the ways they're building AI into their products, all in an effort to help you accomplish everyday tasks faster and easier. Google I.O. is where the company shows off what's next. That's never been more important than right now, because so many are turning to ChatGPT for AI.
Welcome to Google I.O.
Google says it's been investing in artificial intelligence for a decade. Their AI is called Gemini. It handles more data and has access to real-time information.
We're also working hard to make Gemini just really easy for everybody to use. So you don't have to have any special skills. You just ask it for what you want and it will help you out.
A new feature in Google Photos lets you ask AI about your collection, like what's my license plate number or when did my kid learn to swim? Google also showed off an AI sidebar in apps like Docs and Gmail, where it can summarize messages, craft complex replies, and help you brainstorm.
It's aware of what you're working on, and it also knows you. It has access to your Gmail and all the files that are located in Drive in a very privacy-compliant way.
Search is getting smarter. It can handle more nuanced questions with personalized AI results. A new travel search planner creates customized itineraries based on specifics like your flight time, hotel location, and preferences. Veo is Google's text-to-video. It can generate high-quality, detailed videos you can further refine with more text. An experimental AI app called Astra can interpret video in real time and offer guidance based on what it's seeing.
This code defines encryption and decryption functions. This appears to be the King's Cross area of London.
Gemini AI on the Pixel phone can listen to phone calls and alert you if something sounds like a scam. And to curb abuse, Google has created a Synth ID system. It adds a watermark to AI-generated images, audio, video, and text.
I really felt like Google was doing I.O. this year, not for people like me, and not even really for developers, but more for investors. More trying to be like, we are going to fight OpenAI. We are going to fight the competition that's coming around, and this is how we're going to do it.
Google has a delicate balancing act here. They want to embrace the future and build AI into all of their products and services, but they also don't want to disrupt their number one revenue stream, which is search advertising. At Google I.O. in Mountain View, California, I'm Rich DeMuro. That's Rich on Tech.